Good evening, everyone. Happy Christmas Eve and welcome to Epic Church Christmas Eve Gathering. It's different than a gathering this year. We're gathering virtually in our own living rooms and sharing this service together. By now, if you're an Epic regular and live reasonably locally, you should have received your Christmas Eve box on your front porch with some of the things that you'll need this evening. I've asked you to wait until now to open it, so you can open it and begin to look through some of the things that we're going to use this evening in our gathering. If you didn't receive a Christmas Eve box, you can still fully participate in this gathering and you won't need any of the items in there. You know, a take-home Advent experience is not new to Epic Church. We have a couple of times sent home Advent boxes to celebrate the Advent season. This year, we've mailed those things to you and we have now put this Christmas Eve box on your porch as we celebrate. In your box, you'll find a white candle. That's the first thing that we're going to use this evening. Behind me are lit the four candles of the Advent season that we've been talking about each week in December. And now we finally light the white candle, the Christ candle, which is the center of the array, representing that hope, love, joy, and peace find their fulfillment in Christ, whose birth we celebrate. It was the angels who said, "Behold, I bring you tidings of good news that is great joy, and it's great joy to all people because unto you is born this day a Savior." What joy a Savior is born. What hope a Savior is born. What love that we've never known before a Savior is born. And what peace, new peace. New peace, peace that we weren't expecting. 30 years later, that baby's cousin would say of him, "Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of man." Indeed, it was a special night, a holy night. And as the carol tells us, it was a silent night. In your Advent box, your Christmas Eve box, you'll also find a special hymnal for this gathering with the lyrics to the songs so that you can sing along as a family, sing along on your own, or just follow along in reflection and worship. Let's worship Him.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, oh, all is bright, round yon virgin mother. Holy face with Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. On a starlit wonder of the night, you came so all would be made right, and the baby that all beheld, the same baby Mary held, is the same God who is holding us now. On a starlit wonder of the night, you came so all would be made right, and the baby that all beheld, the same baby Mary held, is the same God who is holding us now. Oh, the baby that all beheld, the same baby Mary held, is the same God who is holding us now.
The prophet Micah foretold the events of that silent night when he said, "But you, Bethlehem, are small among the clans of Judah, and from you will come a ruler who is great, and he is from the times of antiquity and before the ancient times." On that silent night, in a humble village, Bethlehem. Really, in a humble paddock set aside for livestock, God entered the world. Under the cathedral of the stars, he made himself known as a baby. In your Christmas Eve box, you'll find a gift bag, and in that gift bag, a humble wooden Christmas ornament that depicts the players in that great event that took place on that silent night. And you can enjoy it as a reminder that what we celebrate with all the festivities, all the glitter and all the sparkle, was really a humble entry into our world by the one who loved us enough.
Hope for the hopeless, Emmanuel.
The next thing I'd like you to take from your box is this card. And it's a Christmas Eve reading for you, and if you're with your family, for you and your family to do together. At the end of the reading, I'd ask you to take some time to share some thoughts about what some gifts that we could give to Christ in the same way that the wise men gave gifts. So now I'm going to silently read here while you at home read together this reading, and then I'll also give us enough time for you to talk together or to consider alone what it might look like to give a gift to the Christ child this Christmas. If you need a little more time to consider how you might worship as the wise men did, you can pause the video here and take that time to do so. And when you come back, we'll go on to our next item from your Christmas Eve box. What better way to celebrate the birth of Christ than with a birthday cake? If you received one of our Christmas Eve boxes, inside that box is this little kit, and you just have to add a few ingredients that you probably have around home to put together a little birthday cake for Jesus as part of your celebration this Christmas Eve. I baked one, not from the kit, but it helps me illustrate the point. A red cake with white frosting and green and gold sprinkles helps us see different things about the gift of Christ that we truly receive at Christmas. The gold sprinkles tell us that the child born was indeed the King of Kings. And the green sprinkles remind us that the gift that he gave us was promised by his Father, who gave his one and only Son, that whosoever would believe in him would receive everlasting life. Green, the color of life. The white frosting shows us that we receive that gift because our sins are made clean, white as snow. And the red body of the cake reminds us of the price that God took upon himself to make that possible for us. A Jesus birthday cake that we can celebrate. Also, in your box, you'll find another reminder of the extreme price that God paid to make sure that we could all experience that eternal life and have freedom from our sins. There's another Christmas ornament for your Christmas tree, and this one is in the shape of an engraved nail. This reminds us that the tree behind us that's decorated with all kinds of festive things also represents another tree that would be cut down much later in Christ's life and formed into a cross upon which he would hang to give us our truest gift of eternal salvation. Hope, love, joy, and peace. They come from a baby laid in a manger, born under the Cathedral of Stars, some 2,020 years ago now. What a great celebration it is. But it begs the question that I had you discuss earlier this evening. What can we give to this newborn king?
Hey, E-Kids, I hope you are having an amazing Christmas Eve. In the box, there is something very special for you, and I'm holding it right here. This is something that is going to help you know Jesus even more and to know that he wants to be your best friend. I want you to have an amazing Christmas and happy birthday to Jesus.
bring ba-ra-ba-ba-ba to lay before the king. Ba-ra-ba-ba-ba, ra-ba-ba-ba, ra-ba-ba-ba. So to honor him, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba, when we come. Little baby, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba, I am a poor boy too, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba. I have no gift to bring, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba, that's fit to give our king. Ba-ra-ba-ba-ba, ra-ba-ba-ba, ra-ba-ba-ba. Shall I play for you, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba, on my drum? Mary nodded, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba, the ox and lamb kept time, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba. I played my drum for him, ba-ra-ba-ba. I played my best for him, ba-ra-ba-ba-bum, ra-ba-ba-bum, ra-ba-ba-bum. Then he smiled at me, ba-ra-ba-ba-bum, me and my drum, me and my drum.
What can we give? We give ourselves to him. Our ups, our downs, our highs, our lows, our days, our nights, our talents, our abilities, the mundane moments and the exciting ones. That eternal life that he gave to us is the life that we give back to him as our gift to the newborn king. Thank you everyone for joining us this Christmas Eve. We're glad to have spent the evening with you. As you go on about the rest of your holiday celebrations, we pray that you experience the fullness of God's love through his son Jesus, and thereby experience true peace and real and lasting hope, and really, joy that is unspeakable and full of glory. Merry Christmas.